Well, this isn't exactly the Batman game I've been looking forward to playing. I can't say I've missed this one. I think I borrowed this off my mate back in the day for me Mega Drive, and I have a misplaced sense of loyalty for the film, which also wasn't that great compared with its predecessors. I developed a sense of loyalty for this game, and don't get me wrong, it looks decent enough here. The acting's pretty nice from the clearly not movie cast in the digitized graphics. And it's fairly well put together, I guess. No, fairly well put together, I guess. That's not true, is it though? On the surface, it's pretty well put together. They've done this weird thing with the controls where, well, we've got to be Batman, haven't we? I do love the digitized graphics there, in theory. There's this thing with the controls where they tried to make it play a little bit like Mortal Kombat. You know that thing where you pull down and hit the punch button and it does a uppercut and that's kind of one of your signature moves. Well, he does stuff like that. And the sweeps and things, they feel like Mortal Kombat. And you can see they tried to kind of simulate Mortal Kombat to an extent. You'll see what I mean. Although it's a kind of a platformer, I don't want to decide on these weapons, they don't look cool. Well, they do look cool, I just don't really care what's what. I'd rather play the game. Keep them off. Yeah, well, I don't know how that does, let's do it. I can't remember what you need to do to get through it. But you can kind of see, a little Mortal Kombat-y. And you've got that thing going on with the punches, and that going on. Isn't that all very Mortal Kombat? There we go, he's activated. various Mad Men, Mad Jake. But they turn it into a platformer, and that should kind of work. Kind of. And it kind of does. The thing is, after a while, this gets really tiresome. As you'll see. And it's the rest of the controls that are the real problem. The getting about controls. The controls that you need to actually progress, you know. So, what are you saying? There's access above you. But let's just get rid of the Mad Men first. Mad John. See what we did there. Did he uppercut my uppercut? So, something is above my head. And if I remember rightly, pushing up jumps, which is annoying. The start button does that. Oh, starting A does pause it. Right, there's a way of, and I can't remember what it is, of shooting a rope up, but the controls are so convoluted that I can't figure out what it is. Maybe it's a double. There we go. It's A and B together, but it's really sticky, so you do it. And there's the hole. See that? Very hard to see little black square above my head. That's the hole I've got to shoot through. How did I get into there before? There we go. Oh, see, and this is where the game really falls down. See how I'm double. My pin. Right. I'm now swinging under the hole. I had no control over that, by the way, that whole jumping off it thing. That's it, and then you just gotta jump at the right time while you're swinging under it. And it's really crap. That's rubbish. Now, that looks like something you face to activate. No, doesn't seem to actually do anything. Oh, there we go, Mad Men. Mad Ty. Entire character in Pit Fighter. Another famously digitized game. Famously, not famously. Can't go in there. There's got to be something to do with that. You don't go all the way up there just for a fight. Oh, there you go. Just kick it. Mad Dan. Let's take Mad Dan on. Don't know what I picked up. It was all very unceremonious the way it happened. Uh-oh, he's had some kind of superpowers imbued on him. Bestowed on him. What's the word I'm looking for? I think they were both perfectly valid words for what I was trying to describe. Okay. I want to go down. I want to go down. Do you see what I mean? I want to go down. I want to go down. Let me go down. Oh, I can't get in. I can't get out. And this was the problem I had with this game. It all feels a bit like this. Oh yeah, the door's open. I can't go down, that means. I love the visual style. I love the way that bridge is lit, for example, and the background's coloured. I don't love the way the digitized graphics look really pixelated and a little bit cheap on the colours, but that's just how pixelated digitized graphics come out when you've got a limited palette. I probably didn't want to stand between these two. Oh, what's that about? That's very Pit Fighter. Yeah. And the fights, once you get into a fight with more than one person, it's not very dignified for Batman. He takes a lot of hits. I don't like the way he walks around in a stance. He could at least have like a walk, so walk animation that he defaults to when he's just walking and not fighting. He looks ridiculous otherwise. Come around again, you'll get to something to do with credits as in lives. I quite like the riddle idea. That's cool. Now surely we've got to be able to get down here, because there's no other way to go. I just don't know how to do it. Don't know how. Answers on a postcard, boys and girls. How do we get down? It's going to take me another. See, I've not played this since about 1996, maybe 97. Oh, I don't know what I did there. Some instinct kicked in and I pressed the right button. Hopefully that'll stick with me for the next time I need to do it. I don't know, there's a lot to like in this game, I guess, but there's more to absolutely love. And it went down like a big bag of poo back in the day. Kind of see why. It's not, you know what? If you play the arcade version, you'll know what a tour de force that is, if nothing else. The arcade version of Batman Forever is quite an experience. Oh, come on. It's basically a brawler. All it shares in common with this one is that it has digitized graphics. Oh man, this sucks, the fat one, it really does. This was the worst thing about this not particularly good game, was this. Now, with a bit of work you can do it quite easily, but I'm not prepared to put hours of practice into to do that. There we go. That was worth it, wasn't it? Just for you have to progress, I guess. The arcade version is awesome in its way. It's got digitized graphics like this, but it is a brawler and you've got about 20 people on screen at any one time. And it's chaos and it's brilliant. And it's cheap as well, you know, because it'll like... I can't remember how I got down there. All these moves I'm pulling off. Totally by accident. Was that an arrow? No. See, now if we get back down. All that effort to get up. I'm sure these are the buttons I press to get down. Maybe it's that. No. Oh, I don't like this game. Yeah, and it was just simple and fun to play, and it was cheap at times. And if you put your money in, and you know, you'd lose your money to a cheap death, and that would suck. But if you're damn sight better than this nonsense, I just wish they'd thought it through, you know. Oh. What the thing is, we've still got the Mortal Kombat fighting controls here. All three buttons are taken up with fighting moves. But the game is currently asking me to get down this hole. Now you can see how it's been designed, that it sits in front here. But, man, really? Double tap, up and down, 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 back down, A and down, B and down, C and down, C and down. Now, that's not what I did last time. And Yeah, let's get a bit further. See what's ahead of us. The same baddie in different colour scheme, that's what. So, yeah, I'm kind of done with this, I think. Yeah, and that's why I wasn't very excited about this one. Batman Forever for the Sega Mega Drive. I will not be playing this forever. Thanks for watching.